गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी। टिल नाउ यू हैव स्टडीड द काइनेटिक एनर्जी एंड पोटेंशियल एनर्जी। द इक्वेशंस ऑफ काइनेटिक एनर्जी इज हाफ एम वी स्क्वेयर, वेयर एम इज द मास ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट, वी इज द वेलोसिटी ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट। द फॉर्मूला फॉर पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज पी इक्वल टू एम जी एच, दैट इज मास इंटू जी मीन्स एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी एंड एच इज द height. Now we are going to study the law of conservation. What is the law of conservation? This is a very important topic, law of conservation of energy. So you have to know this. Now if you know any energy, it can just transform from one form to another. Okay, energy can neither be created or destroyed. You cannot create the energy or you cannot destroy the energy. Only thing you can do is you can transfer the energy from one form to another form. Okay, so that is the first point. You can say energy can neither be created or nor destroyed. It can only be transferred from one point to one form to another form. And third one is the total energy before and after transformation always remains constant. Okay, if you will see the energy before transformation and if you will see the energy after transformation, if you will compare this, it is always same or it is always constant. Okay, now we are going to see a derivation which proves this law of conservation of energy. Okay, now the derivation is conservation of energy during free fall of a body. I will take a body which is going to free fall from a point, it is going to fall freely downwards. Okay, and you are going to study the case at point B, at point A and at point C. These three cases you are going to study, and you are going to study what is the total energy. What is the total energy at point B? What is the total energy at point A? And what is the total energy at point C? These three cases you are going to study, and you are going to check whether they are same or they are different. If these three energies are same at the three points, then you can confirm that the law of energy is proved. You can prove this, okay, by this. For this, I have drawn this. You can see B is an object which is kept at height h. Okay, this object, from this is the ground, and from the ground the object is at point B, and I am going to leave this object from the B, and I am going to derive the equations at point B. I am going to derive the equation at point A. I am going to derive the equation at point C. Okay, for this, now see, this is an object which has mass m. It is kept at height h above the ground. Now see here, first condition you are going to study at point B. What is the condition at point B you are going to study? Now you know, as I have explained you, if any object is above the ground, it is at some height, then what happens? It has potential energy. So here it is, the object is at point B. So what will be the potential energy at this point? At point B, potential energy is mgh, and here there is no kinetic energy. That's why here kinetic energy is zero. See, at the start, okay, potential energy is mgh and kinetic energy at this place is zero. So what will be the total energy? Total energy's formula is potential energy plus kinetic energy, means addition of both potential energy and kinetic energy is the total energy. So the total energy, what you will do, you will add these two terms. That's why I have dashed with a different pen, green color, so that you can easily identify the equations. So here potential energy you will take here mgh, kinetic energy you will take zero. If you will add this both, you will get the total energy, that is mgh. So I have marked this equation, first equation. At this point, what is the total energy? Here the total energy is mgh. Now we'll go for the second point. Now object has traveled from point B to point A. This much distance it has traveled. So while traveling, what happens? Potential energy has got converted into kinetic energy. Now here, what equations will become? See here, now as this is the total height it was there, so it was considered here h. Now what happens here? Now it has moved from here till here, so here height also have changed. So it has traveled x distance. So what will be at this point? You will take here total distance minus x you will take. Okay, so what is the total distance? H minus x. Okay, so here I have written here at point B, second condition, at point A you are going to study. As it falls, what happens here? Potential energy gets converted into kinetic energy. So what happens here at this condition? Potential energy will be mg. Now instead of h height, what you will take? H minus x you will take. okay, there is a change in height. And kinetic energy, what you will take, as you know, its general formula is half mv square. Here v value changes because there is a velocity, it is falling from point B to A, means velocity here changes. What is the velocity that you are going to find out? As you know, if you want to find the velocity, you can take the Newton's equation, equations of motions. Okay, in that third equation I have used here, because as it contains g and x, the term we have contained. Okay, so v square equals to u square plus 2, actually it is as, s means height. Okay, so as it has traveled this much height, so here it is taken x, and it is due to gravity, so instead of a it is taken here g. Now what happens here, v square equal to 2gx, means here u as the initial velocity, here it is g 0. In kinetic energy we have taken over here, kinetic energy it was 0, so initially it was 0, so u has become 0 and v square equal to 2gx. Okay, so this v square you are going to put in this kinetic energy, half mv square. So the kinetic energy is equal to half mv square equal to half into mass into this 2gx I have put here. So here this 2 will get cancelled, only remain mgx. So kinetic energy is equal to mgx. Okay, I have as there also I have dashed here with green so that you can identify which equation you are going to put for the total energy. So here total energy is equal to potential energy plus kinetic energy. This equation you are going to substitute over here, mgh minus x plus here this kinetic energy mgx you are going to substitute here. Here you can see minus x plus x will get cancelled, only remaining mg and this h. Here mg as it is I have taken here common, only remaining h. So here also total energy will be mgh at the point A. This is the equation number 2. As you know, you can see equation number 1 is also mgh, equation number 2 also is mgh, means here and here the total energies are same. Now we are going to study for the third condition at point C. Totally it is now reached to the ground. Okay, so as it has covered the height h, now for the last condition here I have written at point C, as it reaches the ground here, totally the potential energy is converted into the kinetic energy now. So potential energy will be 0 and kinetic energy, you have to find the equation here. Kinetic energy becomes mgh. Here directly I have taken mgh because same way, same using this equation as here v square was 2gx. So here what happens? Here v square is this, okay, mgx over here. How it came? Similarly, same way it has came, half mv square, only the difference is here it was x because it has traveled x distance now, and that's why there is h, because from here till here at this third condition it has totally traveled h. Okay, otherwise same here, instead of writing double I have taken similarly value over there also, mgx, because it has traveled this much, third case it has traveled whole height, so mgh. Okay, now putting these two values in the total energy, you will get, adding 0 plus mgh, you will get mgh. Third case also is same, means at three different points you can see the total energy came is same. So this proves that if you will take at any point, if you will take the equation, you will find the total energy will always remain same. Only here what happens, potential energies get converted into kinetic energy. So this law is proved. Hence you can see the sum of kinetic energy and potential energy is same at the all points. Okay, so potential energy plus kinetic energy is equal to, it is a constant term, so it can prove that this law. Hence the law is proved over here. Okay, understood? The three equations are same in each different points. Okay, so this all derivation you will write in the notebook. As I have explained you before, this is very important, law of conservation of energy, and this derivation also. There can be question can come for see this too. Okay, write the law of conservation of energy, also derive it. Okay, or also prove the law of conservation of energy. So you have to prove with this derivation. This is a very simple derivation. Write in your notebook and complete it till here. Okay, thank you.